Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 19, Nasdaq up 29, S&P's up 4.5. Let's go over to my man, Mr. Teddy Kekstadt, as we do each and every Wednesday at 40 past the hour. And every trading day, folks, you can reach Teddy at forex-trading-unlocked.com. That's forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy Kekstadt, what's going on, brother?
Good morning, guys. Good to see you guys again.
Morning,
you too,
Teddy.
Man. You too. No doubt, man. How's life?
Things are good. We have some interesting scenarios to talk about today with the currency markets.
I like it. Let's do it, man.
Where do you want to start?
I want you to sell about 1,000 contracts in the dollar index first.
That's a good place to start. Sure. Okay.
Yeah, right. Well, the dollar index, I think, is going to see a lot of action, I think, the next couple of days. We have some economic numbers that are going to affect it that are coming out. We have the CPI today. And we have the import-export index numbers coming out tomorrow, and then Friday, I believe, is retail sales. So all of which I think are going to give a little bit of a stir to the currency markets. Reason being is that they're also bond market numbers. And with the stance now that we know that there's a little pressure to the Fed, and probably might be cutting the rates possibly in the not-too-distant future, I think that's going to have a little bit of a play on the currencies, especially the dollar.
Yes.
And remember a couple of weeks ago, we were looking for a bounce and the currencies against the dollar, which we did get over the past few weeks, depending on which currency cross you're looking at. Some were a little bit more extreme. But now we have a divergence going on. So the U.S. dollar seems to be gaining strength against all of the lesser major currencies like the Canada, the yen, and a couple other currencies.
Okay.
But we have the euro and the pound today, which were slightly higher while the other ones were lower. So, but now they're starting to fade and pull back. So I think that if you start to see the euro US dollar turn towards making new lows today, especially settling lower, I got a sell signal on Monday in that market with the high being your risk level. And so far, if they tried to challenge it today and they failed. The same is going on in the British pound. So I think that if those start to erode and become a bear, then you're going to see dollar strength come into the market, in which we're going to start to see a new trend. And then the dollar index obviously would be rallying against that, going higher then.
Interesting. Yeah, so you're saying that the euro, you know, for the last couple of weeks, we went from 111, you know, hit, we were at 113. So you're figuring that the euro pulls back, right?
Right, right. Well, last Friday was the blow-off top, I think, for that rally.
Okay.
So. And I think that's a good level to trade against for both the pound and for the euro would be Friday's high. So if you're a bear, I wouldn't want to be short above that.
Nice.
Yeah, and that's where if you're watching Tiger TV, folks, that was quite a move Friday, huh? 112 to 113.48, huh? Yeah.
Right, right. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So. Interesting.
And the yen, I know you like the yen,
yes.
Guys. So I think that if this dollar is turning, then you're going to see the U.S. dollar yen pound. The U.S. dollar yen will turn around then.
Okay. So we're 108.40. Are you looking for like a 110 again, or what are we looking for there?
I would say, yeah, probably. I think that's a good little area. Now, I'm not looking for a major turn. That's not at all what I'm looking for, because we have the G20 meeting coming up in a couple weeks.
Yep.
You know? So I think that if your listeners are trade, especially like the euro, you had a monster move over the past like a week and a half. But that looks like a monster move because it's been in such a tight range for 6 months.
Right.
A $2 move all of a sudden looks like it was something crazy happened in the markets, right?
Right. So you're really looking for consolidation from kind of where we are with all of these probably, right? Is that what we're looking at?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, I can see that.
That's what we're going to do is we're going to start to establish the upper end of what's going to be a range trade for the next couple of months.
Okay, cool.
Nice.
Yeah, no, you can see that. I can definitely see that because we had fast movement, right? After fast movement, it's got to take a breather, right? All of them probably.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right. Now, what can happen is if we do get a rate cut in the U.S., then that's going to cause either a big move up to raise the range or to press the range lower, depending on the currencies. So,
yeah.
But that remains to be seen. We need a rate cut for that to happen. Otherwise, I think what we're doing is we're just establishing a wide range. It's not going to be, and I don't think we're going to see the euro up at 125, let alone going down to parity, you know?
Right.
So, but with the Swiss, that's another key indicator too is let's see what happens with that. If it can make a rally up to parity, you know, and hold above that, well, then we know that the dollar definitely is gaining strength again. And we'll probably see that it's back above making new highs, probably up to 103, 104 handle. Okay. You know, obviously this would be over the next month and a half. This is not going to happen over the
next month. Swiss came down quite a bit, right? 102 to, actually, it was 99. I mean, that's 4 months, but that's interesting, right? I mean, that's...
Right.
The dollar didn't have that much movement weakness compared to what the Swiss has done here.
Sure. And the Canada did the same thing. If you guys look at a daily Canada chart... Okay. With just a week and a half, you have the highest high and the lowest low on the chart past 4 or 5 months.
Yeah, that's quite a move, man.
Yeah, so, and that's why I think there's that looking at this divergence in the currencies, if they're the leading indicator, like remember how 2 weeks ago we looked for the Swiss and the Canada to be, they were the first little indicator that the dollar was turning. So now maybe this is the same thing that's occurring again today or over the past couple sessions. So a rally in the U.S. dollar Swiss, a rally in the U.S. dollar Canada, which is going on. And look at that low in the Canada. That low was a gap open lower, and then it closed above the low of that big exacerbated down day prior to that.
So what he's looking at, folks, is that the low of the big day was 132.62, and then you closed that 132.69. I see. Okay, cool. Yeah, you know what's going to be wild, man? I mean, is that, you know, you look at these interest rates, it seems like interest rates are going down all over the world. So it's like, who's going to get the lowest rates? And I guess it's going to be the currency is going to be whoever has the highest rates of the lowest rates, right?
Right, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Right. Who would have thunk that, too? I mean, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, if you were going to say that we'd be riding low rates like this for as long as we have, I think everyone would scratch their heads and be like, what are you talking about?
Seriously. I think you're right.
Seriously.
Right?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, it's you know, we were just talking to Kevin Hinks earlier, and it's hard to wrap your head around that, you know, the economy seems to be going fine. And if you look at the Fed Fund Futures rate, was the July one was, what, 89%?
80% for a cut at the next meeting, not June. Yep.
In July.
Yep.
And there's a 2%, no, in September, was it September or October, that there was the probability of 48% to get two rate cuts.
Yeah, so the third meeting from now, it's almost like a 50% that there's two cuts by within three meetings, counting June as the first. Right. Yeah.
Pretty wild.
That makes me... Are you guys curious about why they would actually really be cutting rates right now? I think this is not the time to be cutting rates.
That's what we're talking about.
It's almost going to be interesting no matter which way they go, right, Teddy? It's like if they do that many cuts, like, wow, is the market going to go through the moon? And then it's like, but what if they don't? Because it's like priced into the Fed fund futures. There's going to be a reaction on that side as well.
And then if they
there's good arguments on both sides.
No, there is. And if they do, I think what you're saying is that okay, what's going on out here? What do we have that we don't know, right? what's out here that we don't?
They're supposed to be ahead a little bit, you know, but to be cutting at all time highs and geez, what are they ahead of? Yeah.
Listen, folks.
Yes.
Every trading day, check it out, forex-trading-unlocked.com. That's forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy, you have a great week, safe week, man. We look forward to speaking next Wednesday.
Sounds great.
Thanks, Teddy.
Take care. Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I come right back. Dow's flat, Nasdaq's off 19, S&P's down 2.5. We'll come right back.